I would like to introduce my teacher, Lompo Thien, Jitta Supo. In my faith, in my understanding, see, is the great master meditation in Thailand, because he is the one of the master that he creates his own technique how to understand the Dhamma. How I understand, how I met him, when in 1988, at the early of the year, I went to the vegetarian shop at that Suan Chattuchak in Bangkok, and nearby have the bookshop, and I went to see, to find some book, and the owner of that book is, he is a study at the same university with me before, and he remember me, and later he introduced me to know Lompo Thien book, and I opened his book and I found that his technique in the picture how to do meditation by moving hand. And at the time I still smoke. I smoke 8 years more, and every day I smoke 1.5 packet of cigarettes. That very much smoking, and I try to stop, but I cannot. And after I bought a Lompo Thien book and read, and I not understand too much, but I found that his technique to make our hand is busy all the time, it may help me to stop smoking. And one day I went to see my mother, and my mother wished me to ordain. In Thai tradition, all the son or the man should ordain for 3 months or some time before get married and earn their family life. Me myself is when I was 20 years old, I don't want to ordain. At the time I joined with the political activity, political, and at the final I joined with the Communist Party, and went to the jungle when I that early years, when the military did the coup d'etat in 1976. And when my mother asked me to ordain, I agree with her and ordain for 3 months. But I talked with them, the owner of the bookshop, asked him to brought me to stay with Lompo Thien Temple, Wasanam Nai, and he arranged for me when I ordained. When I took ordination, when I came out from the Sima Horn, I have the half packet of cigarette I give to the other and start to stop smoking. At that time is very, very serious time, because I'm really so hungry to smoke. And how will I do? How could I do it? I tried to moving hand and walking, meditation. At that time I just lead, and I don't know clearly about walking meditation, just walk forward and backwards. So I did that in my room by myself. When I'm very hungry, I move my hand very fast, I just to stop release the hunger from the smoking. I did that for 3 days, and I found that I feel all the sensation around my body, and I don't feel hungry to smoke anymore. And I found that our body is have the, their own function, such as have to, when hungry have to eat, when the feel to go to the toilet, we have to go to the toilet and have rest. Why we put more things to our body. So when I realized that, I found that I can stop smoking from inside. It doesn't come from the lesson that I did before. When I stop smoking, at that time I keep like I know what the lesson, how bad, how not good to smoke, but when I very strongly make commit myself to the lesson like that, but at the final I cannot. So when I did that, I found that I can stop smoking. During the rainy season, I went to Wat Sanam Nai and stay there and met Long Ho Thien at Wat Sanam Nai. And that year he spent for the rainy season at Thap Mi Kwan in Loi province. And he came to Bangkok and stayed at Wat Sanam Nai. And he gave the Thapa talk. Even that time I know that he was very sick. He got the intestine cancer. He have two time operation and take two intestine out, and he have only one intestine. He have ever been talk with the disciple that he would like to lead this road, but the disciple that asked him to stay because he was sick, and he can contribute the Dhamma, and he agreed with the disciple. And he did. So he eat a little can earn their life, but very difficult. I know that he was very painful. And he makes, at that year, he made the last decision of his life. He wished to organize Thap Mi Kwan to be the center or to train the dynamic meditation teacher to help contribute this technique in the country and maybe in around the world in the future at that time. But unlucky that he was very sick. And in September, he went to the stay in the hospital, Summit Divet Hospital, and he was investigated very seriously, and he was appointed to go back again on 13 September. He came out from the hospital on the 6th September, and during that time, it looked like he made a decision himself. At the final, he told the disciple buy the ticket to fly back to Loi province, and he said, buy only one way ticket. That means the disciple realized that he maybe went to Thap Mi Kwan and he would be passed away there. So the disciple who had the money, he tried to talk with him how much money they will pay for him to carry on his life. But he told the disciple that disease the doctor can cure, but life doctor cannot cure. So by this words that he gave to the disciple, we are all accept what he feel. And on the 9th September, in the early morning, I myself and other monks helped to carry his wheelchair. He sit on the wheelchair and carry him across the railway to the van. And when he stand up from the get off from the wheelchair, he stand up. I saw him. That is the last time that I saw him. He feel very happy, and he see aloud. It look like the last time for his life to stay in this temple at Wat Sanam Nai. So when he went to Loi province, after I know from the monks that I keep close to him is Long Pu Ma San Tamano, and also Pa Cha Niloto. He is an Australian monk who ordained and keep close to Long Ho Thien, and he take care of Long Ho Thien in the last period of life. And I know that when he went back to Thap Mi Kwan, he stopped to use any medicine. Even his pain is very strong and serious. Long Pu Ma San Tamano asked him that, as you teach you have rupa, rupa, rupa kham is not tukha, is no tukha. You have the corporality is no tukha, feeling is no tukha, perception is no tukha, mental formation is no tukha, consciousness is no tukha. And can you do this? And he shook his head that in terms of accept that he can do. That means he can see the pain of the body as the body pain. He don't take in terms of the mind no attached to the body. That's really, really wonderful thing that we found. If the person can do like this, they can face the last minute of life peacefully. In the on 13 September, about 4 p.m., he told his disciple, "Peace be blessed," like that. And all the disciples tell each other, "Maybe Long Ho will pass today," because he born in the 5th September on the Tuesday, and the 13th September 1988, when he was 77 year old, also Tuesday. And after the disciple sitting around the table that he laid out there, and they are doing meditation with a moving hand, and he do something like a peaceful until six, the quarter past six, he passed away peacefully. And he told the disciple that keep his dead body only not more than 7 days, because when the person died, the dead body looked like nothing, have no any meaning. And anyway, even he told like that, the disciple discuss and keep his dead body and do the funeral in the year later. This is about his life that I know. For me myself, the monk who ordained at the year he passed away, and most of the monk who ordained at that year is now they all dislocated. Only me still alive, I am still in the monkhood. Long Ho Tien is he enlightened when he was a layman in the year he's 46 year old. Before that, he do the merit, especially do the Katina. Give love to the monk who stay in the temple for 3 months. At that year, he did 3 places, the Katina, and he give the work for his wife to take care of the money, and he himself is keep 10 precepts, look like the novice, and don't touch the money. But during the play finish and the night time to celebrate the Katina, and his wife has asked him pay the money for the prayer on now or not, and he feel upset. After they do the Katina finish, he come at the evening time, he talk with his wife, and his wife asks him, "I ask him like that, are you like that, you upset?" And he said, "Yes, I am upset." And he said, if you upset, that means you go to the hell." Because of that verse, he feel that he would like to overcome the angry or the hatred mind in this life, and he planned himself, he collect the money, give to his wife. At the final, he left the family. I think if he don't enlighten or find out the can overcome the anger, he didn't come back. But at that year, he found himself, he enlightened, and he can overcome the anger emotion. And he came back home and set the Vipassana him center by his money himself and teach his cousin, especially his wife, until he do like that 2 and 8 months, 2 years and 8 months, till his wife and understand the Dhamma very clear, also his cousin. After he told his family he would like to contribute the Dhamma more and will be good if he ordained to be a monk. And he ordained to be a monk in 1960, and he passed away in 1988. That he contribute the Dhamma more than 20 years old. And his teaching is still till now, especially in English version. The first English version is alive in Singapore when he went to Singapore and give the Dhamma talk and do the Litis meditation there. The first book come from there is the topic is Two Wonder Field, and later is still have other translation such as Normality and Manual of Awareness like that. So this is my teacher. I think Long Po Tien nowadays, even he passed away for a long time, but his teaching is still very powerful, and the person who read his book still keep his teaching as his keyword to do the meditation, especially the dynamic meditation by moving hand and walking meditation. That's very good.